after he came back from France and he was married, and, you know.
Srul's brother Norman.
And, gee, there's no cash flow. Shock, surprise, you know. And so he called Lou Applebaum. Said, Lou, I need a job. Lou said, well, give me some time and let me see what I can do for you. And, you know, 6 months later, he called him back and said, you know, go down to CBC and talk to somebody there and see if you qualify and if they'll accept you. And, he went down there.
And I got a job as a radio producer in 1962,
after I came back from France. You got the job, $6,000 a year, which was, in those days, I guess we consider that a good beginning. And it was exciting. It was demanding. It was nerve-wracking at first. And there was a lot of work for him to do as a producer.
There was such an excitement of things happening in the world of music. We were building music in the country for the CBC. We had the idea that we were making things happen. We were giving performers an opportunity to be heard. At one particular time, I was producing music for 4 different recital periods weekly. It was just thrilling. When I came back from Paris, France, and I got the job at the CBC as a radio producer, I was still very young. And I feel that those years of reading scores and working with the finest conductors and musicians from around the world and in Canada, we have such great musicians here, was a postdoctoral degree of high proportion. My reading skills, my musical skills, my formal skills, my stylistic skills all honed themselves. And it's very interesting. It helped me make the decisions about what kind of composer I wanted to be very clear.
The insecure composer who'd gone to Paris to find his voice had made another discovery. In the search for a modern, secular voice, he'd grown away from his Jewish roots.
He'd moved away from the family involvement, Jewish involvement. He wasn't concerned about keeping the traditions and all that. And then finally, when we came back from Paris and he came back, and the family meant a great deal to him. And I think that being away from them made him aware of how much it meant. And then as the children came, he wanted an identity, and so he started to get involved. Shortly after Paula was born, he was invited to be the choir conductor of the Beth Tikva, and that changed his life completely.
They had a very, very devout, focused rabbi by the name of Fetter, who really got a hold of Srul and really influenced tremendously. And he was becoming more devout and more devout. and was really brought into a very, very strict observance that none of our family really understood, especially his siblings.
I mean, that was really a big thrust towards the Jewish music. That was a place for him to belong. It was a place of recognition. He had a real relevancy there. And I think he blossomed. He started to blossom in a certain way because of that involvement. It gave him a place.
And so that took a hold of him, not only in his whole lifestyle and his beliefs, but it also took command of his music direction.